Can you imagine living without food for a day? Well, on Agenda SOS today, that is the plight of flood victims in the Upper East region. They lost everything to the floods and have virtually nothing to hold on to.
May it be when darkness falls, your heart will be true. You walk a lonely road, oh, how far.
The United Nations reports that 821 million people are living with hunger as of 2018, and 2 billion people are expected to be chronically undernourished by 2015, a problem the Sustainable Development Goal 2 is targeting to eradicate. With floods and droughts, progress towards the goal is going off track as hunger is rising in some countries, especially in Africa. Ghana is probably adding on to the numbers. Floods are leaving many in the northern part of the country with no food.
As I'm telling you, there's nobody that will get a half bag of millet for the family. You can't get it, I bet. Look at them. Look at it. What are you going to pick from? Nothing. And the animals that we always rely on. If they ask somebody to count about two or three goats, you're telling a lie. Where they used to, the animals are staying, and they have collapsed on some of them. There's nothing that we rely on.
They survived but lost everything. Their source of livelihoods lost to rising water levels, which ripped through the farmlands at the time crops were ready for harvest.
These dark, fertile farmlands have provided livelihoods for thousands over generations, but they turned into new fishing grounds in the October floods. Farmers watched their produce wash away in the floods. They say heavy rains in the month of October is unusual.
Farm about 6 acres, and then the rain came and then it has spoiled everything. So this is what is left at the where the rain does not go there, and then he managed to harvest this. He actually know that hunger will come.
Ben mama tere dina ye numoro do tumdi zenda anto kunto mo do tulori ama basa ye di tokro wolda anto. Ankara kan ye naba ne tutumba bape ankara kan mana.
Everything is condemned, so there will be famine this year. So we want people to support us. Like, if we want to mention the needs of the people for now, it's food. We need food to help the people.
Left with virtually nothing to eat, hopes and aspirations are in disarray. Hungry, weak, frail, and mourning.
May it be when...
It's just that it's very hard. Some of our government will help you, they are helping to help. I don't get anything to do. I don't get anything to do.
To eat is difficult for us to be. We are suffering, please help us. Because of it, we can't get food to eat.
Children, the elderly, and people with disability are worse affected.
Find your way.
I did myself.
It's unbearable in many ways that, you know, we can count on three meals to eat and there are people who have one meal a day. That should not be the case. And the whole perspective of human development is precisely that, that no one should be left behind, that there should be basic rights, that there should be basic entitlements, that there should be basic opportunities for everyone.
It's 6 a.m. and it is midday. We haven't seen much of cooking going on here. Even though the people are hungry, They say there's virtually nothing to cook. They have lost everything in the floods. Not more is yet to cover lots of places. The farther you go, the more desperate the situation. For the people here, time is of essence, and further delays will only worsen their plight.
Say about mutimo boya na monye ayi aduane kakra bia na odimaya na edie hweya mba no a oni sa afidra na edie betima aduye aduane na mana ayeya maye.
The rains has affected the performance of the crops. So if they can assist with food to feed the family, he will be very grateful.
Adam Ayizanab is drying what he was able to salvage from his 3-acre farm for himself, wife, and 3 children.
I come on to the party in Yamudela. I am come on. I am a party in Yamudela.
So far, you are Japan.
I never mean a letter to Pilitan to Diana or about Diana. The men and men.
Now, Paika Bata.
It's a serious disaster. In some places, they will declare an emergency,
a complete national emergency. And yet, my vocabulary for emergency may be different from somebody's vocabulary for emergency. Obviously, it was not an emergency for those who have the power to declare an emergency. And what emergencies can then bring up. We think it's an emergency because our people are suffering. They are dying. They are helpless.
That for me would also have been too much to request for. When you declare a state of emergency, that's a red flag, you know. Yeah, you have the. I don't think we got into the red zone. May have just been within the yellow zone.
Government Disaster Management and Prevention Body NATMO reached the affected with some food handouts, but which was not enough, according to residents.
This is what is given to them. The whole family. This is what is given to them. Why are they going to lay down their heads and prepare this? Are they going to be chewing them raw? Are they saying it? Is it an anointed rice? If I tell the number of vehicles that came here, that fuel could have accumulated the money and support this house, but I would have been joined.
Many did not receive the handouts.
What is omo chiche eduane? Omo nche wu.
Gabi. Yan kya bi. Yan fa die ne bia ma kya ma hada.
Omo ba fie ina emu wan dia omo mbo me bia. Ni ebuye no ni be kura ba ha no. Wa de koro me na wa snap me. Zo ko ya no. Omo ba ya me fie. Enene.
Unfortunately, that's the much that we can do. When disaster strikes, not everybody your hand can reach, but you try as much as possible to reach out to the people and then make sure that their life is a bit comfortable.
First, we don't really have at all, humanitarian organizations in Ghana. I mean, that can do large-scale humanitarian disaster response. There are no NGOs who are like Oxfam. Oxfam does development programs, but they're also known for their humanitarian intervention. Or the Red Cross in Kenya. So I think in 3-4 years ago, there was a terrible drought in the northeast of Kenya. Thousands of animals were dying. It was the Red Cross, together with other civil society organizations, that mobilized the private sector and created a campaign called Kenya for Kenyans, where several people made small donations through mobile money. They mobilized over $100 million worth of responses.
Right, in the sense that our silence is inexcusable. If we are indeed working for the well-being of Ghanaians, and with paying particular attention to the vulnerable and the poor, I mean, this should have excited commentary from us, you know, as to what is happening. We need a strong civil society voice pointing in that direction.
The Vice President, His Excellency Dr. Mahmoud Paumia, also donated 50,000 cedis in support of the victims across the entire Upper East region.
We sat down the DCEs and decided how to disperse the money to the families. It wasn't actually based on districts. It was based on the victims. It wasn't enough to solve their problems. It was only an attempt on the government to appreciate the distance and that to show the concern that they are with them. But as and when the need arises, the government will be here to support them.
Government has announced nearly 200 million cedis as part of efforts to curb flooding in the capital, Accra. They are yet to say anything about the northern floods.
Why is it that no similar response comes when it comes to places in rural areas, especially northern Ghana? How could it be that lives in Accra priced higher than lives, you know, in Navrongo or Boku or Bongo or Sandema area? How? It's something is terribly wrong with the values and the psychic of public leadership in this country.
Humanitarian assistance is required, but several days have passed and no humanitarian agency has been to those affected.
Right now, as it is, there are coordination meetings that are taking place. NADMO is taking the lead. The UN agencies, including WFP, are attending these meetings, and we are waiting for information from them and for a letter, if that the government so desires to send us a letter of request.
For how long? It's getting too late. The longer it takes, the further it is from the hearts and minds of anybody.
What we can do is to speed up those kinds of, ask them to speed up, but especially in Ghana, which is a country where we help with development. I mean, if when war breaks out in other places, even with the bombings, etc., you still need the government permission. We can't walk in. It's impossible to just get into a situation.
Civil society has been quiet about the flooding all over the country, especially the north, where many people have been killed and thousands of hectares of farms destroyed.
Our silence is inexcusable. If we are indeed working for the well-being of Ghanaians and paying particular attention to the vulnerable and the poor, I mean, this should have excited commentary from us, you know, as to what is happening. We need a strong civil society voice pointing in that direction.
Civil society organizations are generally missing in disaster preparedness and response activities.
It would be useful to convene a discussion and get public commitments to action. What should be done? There has to be an internal mobilization, because I do believe there are people in this country who can support in small ways to be able to provide relief.
Development activists are chiding members of parliament for turning a blind eye to the plight of the affected persons in these times of difficulties. The next planting season is one that is not guaranteed unless help comes now to avoid any further disaster.
If the international agencies are not coming in, it is maybe because we have reassured them that we have the capacity to deal with this, and we have not declared it as an international emergency.
We come in when there's a request. A year ago, there was no request. There were also some floods. There was no request for food support. And so we didn't go in.
Those at the end, the receiving end, are dissatisfied with what has been provided. I think we have to come together to raise our voices and say, look, we are suffering. Whilst Ghana is telling the world that we are capable of dealing with our problems, we on the ground are suffering. The help is not coming. Blankets and a few 5 kilo bags of rice will not take us to March, February, March, April next year.